powder, yeah, was brought in by foreign missionaries of Nigerian descendants. Okay. When it started, I think it was around about, I would say 1998.
Yeah. Mr. Demon, can I ask you a question? Please, then I want your honest answer.
Oh, yes.
Fine, I hear your explanation right now. See, you know, this issue you are talking about is far beyond an individual's. You know that, it's far beyond an individual's. So I asked Mr. Val before he left the panel, what is your complaint to your government? What is your government putting in place to make sure that this thing is not in circulation in your community again? What are they putting in place? What are they doing?
Look, we've got systems in the world, you know, like for instance in Thailand, in China, in Korea, and where they've barricaded every region, every chance of these things coming in. Why in Africa our systems are poor, right? Why in Africa our systems are poor? In Africa we are trying everybody to be accommodated. But now, if let's say you are being accommodated to come and do business in that country, and then you come with a wrong business, and then you are killing the whole nation. Actually, you are killing. Why can't we be so honest? You say, okay, you are my brother, ne? You are going to where? Let's say you are going to Ghana. Make us proud in Ghana. Make us proud. We don't want the prisons in Ghana. They said, yeah, it's full of Nigerians. For instance, the prisons are full of Nigerians. We've got Nigerians in our prisons. Because of
like how many Nigerians? Your statistics show that there are about 24,000 to 25,000 Nigerians living in SA. And when last your criminal records of your country came out by your officials, the less normally the 77%, I think South Africa would be much because you are the owner of the land. Then the other nationality are like 23%, but fact to say, you cannot even see any percentage Nigeria occurring that 23%. So see, what I just want to say, Mr. Gamon, is that see, this issue of powder that you guys are talking, you have the right to fight for your country, you have the right to be patriotic concerning your country. But this issue is far beyond an individual. This issue, like now, you said something that the continent is losing, anybody can come in, fine. But you know, in our own country, Nigeria, once they see you with powder coming to the country with powder or even selling within the country, is daytime. So we have strict laws concerning all these things. Strict laws. Laws. So even me, I'm speaking to you, I've not even seen it like this in my life. Likewise, you can ask every other Nigerians staying in Nigerians or the one outside Nigeria. So the issue is that your government is not taking street laws concerning it. That's why you should continue having the same issue. Okay, assuming now that you said, okay, it's Nigerians. Okay, or if every Nigerian leave your country, do you think that powder issue will be resolved? I want you to answer the question, Mr. Gilbert.
The powder now has been transferred.
So, if you want to stay in your country,
let us be sincere with each other. Okay, now you guys consider that every Nigerian leave your country. Do you think that powder issue will be solved?
Pastor, the powder.
I'm hearing you, my brother.
The powder has been transferred, to the locals. Now in my street where I live, the street of 15 houses, of 20 houses, we've got three people who are selling this damn thing. The skill.
So
the skill. Look here. The skill has been taught.
Continue, brother.
The skill has been taught by the foreigners, no? Long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
So people, they wanna get quick money. By what? By destroying other.
Let me just add this question. That will reach my mic. Then you close up. Then give on that person. You should time to talk. I know you said that the skills have been transferred to the locals. Now this is where you people need to go to cancel it. Take, bring out some programs. Educate people on it. Educate people on it. When you educate people more, to tell people more about the effects, the dangers of this thing. You see, even the one that has been addicted to it, they can go for rehabilitation, and all this thing based on your community also. Because now you need to take back your children from it. And is there any program like that being laid down in your community or in your state, in your country?
I so wish one day I would.
They will never answer your direct question. They won't answer your question directly.
Pastor, sorry, I want to tip in small now, please. Do you think South African people want to stop the powder in their country? They don't want to stop powder in their country. They're just jealous that the Nigerian people came to involve. Madam, please, if you can wait. What is it, your Lambo or whatever? If your mouth is running like that, please, you can drop and go to your platforms where you do nonsense there, please. Where you drag and roast Nigerians, don't come here and disrespect. They don't want to stop it. They don't want it to stop in their country. They just want Nigerians that is involved, one or two Nigerians that is doing it to stop doing it. They want to take over. If they want to stop it, they know what to do.
Because you know, my sister, my madam, because this thing, if Nigerians eventually left, this thing is not going to stop. Because
and you know, many people are doing affected. They don't want it to stop.
You need to educate people rather than you people ranting so much on social media that it's wrong nationality, is wrong this, wrong that.
You guys need to go to education, educate people. You have set up rehabilitation center to rehabilitate people that is far. Is affecting them. So by gradually, this thing. If the demand went down, even they will need to run away because there's no money there again. But Mr. Dion, I hope you are getting what I'm saying.
Don't know,
there must be a campaign, strong campaign about it. That this thing,
Pastor Dino, you are wasting your time on somebody like this. I've spoken to him like a couple of months ago. For him to have the same mindset and the same mind up to now, he has not learned.
I beg, now another person speak. Mr. Castle. Please, let's have a solution for like
we have
2 minutes before we give language time.
We've got the amazing South African ones, which are willing to have a change. Yeah. But you see somebody like going on, you're wasting your time with him. You're wasting your big time with him. Trust me.
Rachel, you are not listening to the conversation. All you want to do is bashing on people.
Sit down.
All you want to do is your bashing on people.
My guys are facing a problem. We have to come to South Africa. If I go to South Africa, you bring me Mama Taraxi. Prostitution.
Come on, get that from there. This expired jalapeno. Come on, get that from there.
Why are you preaching to them?
Hello,
today is water service.
Good afternoon, everybody. I want all of you to understand something. The very day I know these people are clown is the very day they refuse to vote for a presidential candidate that will have liberated South Africa, a man called Julius Malema. The reason why they refused to vote for that man was because he said he cannot discriminate any African country, Nigeria, Zimbabwe, anybody. So they said for the fact he supported Nigeria, they are not going to vote for him. And now I was surprised. When I leave with our brother that was there for you people, that want to help you people. I was meant to understand that in that same stupid South Africa, you people are even wasting your time talking about. There are specific areas that the blacks are not cannot go there, and they own South Africa. So my brothers and sisters, those people does not even watch your time. I swear, if the time when I talk to Tinubu, it go air pass. Now the most useless topic for the country. So that one air pass. I don't know why Miss Richard they waste her voice. They talk to those people. They don't even know their problem.
Say my brother, no. I bet. Rachel, no, they waste her voice. Rachel, no, they waste her voice. They here. They give Niger people bad name for months now. Rachel, really try. Everybody must talk about Tinubu. Rachel, wait now.
I know my talk.
Everybody must.